What if I were to tell you that you can have this mini ecosystem in your courtyard or balcony where you can have fresh fruits and vegetables and also fishes? Yes, this is possible thanks to aquaponics. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I am Richa and I'm excited to present to you a fascinating blend of ancient Indian agricultural wisdom and cutting-edge technology, aquaponics, enhanced with data modeling and artificial intelligence. As the renowned scientist Norman Borlaug once said, that food is the moral right of everyone who is born into this world. Aquaponics, pioneered by Dr. Mac Mahmurthy, is basically marrying aquaculture and hydroponics together. So what happens here is that the fishes, they are grown, they are provided nutrients, and they are there in the aquarium. Then there is a biological filter and an air pump that takes you to the hydroponics tank. What is hydroponics? Hydroponics is basically growing plants without soil. So you don't need soil to grow plants. So the plants are growing inside without soil. And then there is this biofilter. So what happens is that when you provide nutrients to the fishes excrete, and that excreta is full of ammonia, and it's nutrient rich for plants. That goes to the biofilter. And from that biofilter, basically, all the ammonia is converted into nitrates and nitrites, which can be used by plants. The plants help purify the water, which is recirculated back to the fish tank. And as a result, the fish again gets a purified water. So do you understand? This is like a two sustainable farming system integrated into one, which is utilizing space, utilizing resources. Now, as I told you, your own aquaponic system at home. Imagine having this system in your home. Yes, you can have it. You just need to create one aquarium. You just need to have hydroponics plants, and you need to integrate them. And with a limited space, and then with limited time, you can have your fresh fruits, you can have your vegetables, and you can have your fishes at home, which you can enjoy. So now comes the magic. Like, where is the magic happening in aquaponics in today's world? That is data modeling and artificial intelligence. This sounds very simple, right? And if I were to ask you, how many of you had known about aquaponics before today? Any raises of hand, how many of you have known about aquaponics before today? So India ranks third in the world in aquaponics after USA and Japan. So data modeling and artificial intelligence are like spices on the top of their food. So what happens is that I have placed sensors over there, and sensors actually monitor and collect important data. Important data about what is the water temperature of the aquarium, what is the pH level of this water, what are the nutrient concentrations in the water, what is the light intensity that is needed for fishes, and what is the fish behavior. All of the data can be captured using these sensors. Now what we will do with this data? Are we going to utilize this? Yes. How we are going to utilize it? We are going to combine it using the predictive data analysis. So sensors collect and monitor data, and what they do is we do predictive analysis on top of it. What is predictive analysis? Prediction means predicting what will happen in future. With the data and the patterns they show, we are going to predict what is going to happen in future, and as a result, we are going to take corrective actions for it. So, as I told, the water quality can be measured, the plant growth rates can be measured, the fish health can be measured. These data are sent into the central database, and the data models start analyzing it. Then, for example, if the sensors detect that there is a change in the pH level for the fishes, then what the prediction and the predictive analysis will do, they will prompt corrective action in advance, which they'll tell that, okay, reduce the pH level to a certain extent. Similarly, if the nutrients for fishes go to a certain level and they are really low or they are really high, then the system can prompt to add nutrients or remove excess of nutrients. In the same way, if the water temperature fluctuates, then the heating and the cooling system will adjust the temperature accordingly. As a result, what is happening? You can see with minimal human intervention, a highly efficient system is there, which is combining two ancient agricultural methods, which is hydroponics and as well as aquaculture, and we are combining it into. So aquaponics, aquaculture plus hydroponics is aquaponics, which is marrying two of them. Now, by now, you would have definitely understood that what are the advantages of aquaponics. And before that, I would like to ask you one question. Suppose if we are combining two systems and integrating into one part, what is the first thing that comes to your mind is being saved here? What is the first thing that is being saved? Apart from what is shown in the slide, what is the first thing that is being saved? Anyone, any raises of hands? It's the energy. It's reducing the wastes. So what we are doing is that we are reducing the wastage. So had I had to create aquaculture separately and had I had to do hydroponics separately, then it would have taken me a lot of space. It would have taken me some other resources. It would have taken me extra time to build all of this. But when I am combining these two systems, I am doing it with precision. I am doing it with efficiency. When I say efficiency, it is zero human intervention sometimes. The system is adept in itself to maintain ideal conditions. So fishes, if they feel, for example, the system, if the pH is low, it will itself correct it because we are using data modeling on top of it. Similarly, we are using the resources, we are using optimization technique, and as a result, we are saving a lot of energy. So this is the advantage of having your aquaponic system in this world. And we need to promote it widely in order to have a sustainable future for our children. Now, the concept that has not been implemented yet. I wanted to, apart from what we have currently, what is something which is not there in aquaponics yet, and what can make it more beautiful, and what can add more value to it. So I was thinking of, symbiotic bioluminescent algae. So what they do is they emit light, and when they emit light, there is no need of artificial lights in the aquarium, because we have algae doing it. Similarly, they also release oxygen. When they are releasing oxygen, the fishes are getting oxygen without any intervention and without any extra resources. So, and this algae will also add to the beauty of it. So as a result, this entire system becomes beautiful. That entire system starts using lesser energy, and the entire system becomes very efficient. So this is the system that has not been integrated yet, and I would suggest if in case you are trying to use, or if you are going to talk about aquaponics from today onwards, then I would suggest let's talk about how we can integrate algae into it. Now, there is a famous quote by Albert Einstein that look deep into the nature and then you'll understand everything better. So I would suggest that start using technology into nature, start using how nature, which is already there, how different sources of farming that are already there, and start using technology on top of it, and how the fusion of this technology, artificial intelligence, and data modeling on top of aquaponics is a testament to human ingenuity and technology. I would like to extend my thanks to all the innovators, to all the scientists, and all the researchers in this field. And thank you so much for being a patient listeners. I hope you have a separate ecosystem in your home, in your balcony soon. Thank you.